So, I'm in ItsLearning here, and I have a document that I'm working on online, a collaborative document that I'm able to embed in a course in ItsLearning. You cannot edit this document from within ItsLearning. That's why I have the link here, and if you click this link, you'll be taken to the document where you can edit it. This is a OneDrive Word file, Word Online, and if I want to edit it, I can click here and edit in the browser. And I can work collaboratively with others on this document. I've created a very simple KWL chart. You can create whatever document you would like and have your students or other teachers collaborate on it and then make it viewable in ItsLearning. So if I update this document, it will also update in ItsLearning for me. To create that, we're going to have to go through three steps. First, we have to create the document that we want to share. Next, we have to embed the document that we want to share. And finally, we have to create a link to the document so that you can actually get in and edit the document if you would like to. So, if I'm in OneDrive Online, I can see here is my OneDrive Word documents. If I'm logged in with my school account, we'll just wait for that to load. I'm going to create a new blank document. I can call it whatever I like. I can name it up here, KWL, for example, KWL chart. And in here, I can add anything that I like. I'm just simply going to put test in for now. One tip is to make the font a little bigger. Because you're only using half a page in ItsLearning, if you use the default font size, it's quite small. So if you make the font bigger in your document, it shows up a little better on your ItsLearning site. So I've created the document, and now I want to embed this document into my ItsLearning course. So I go to File, and I want to Share, and you can see here it gives me an embed code. Just a tip. The whole frame from here to here on ItsLearning is approximately 800 pixels. And so you want your frame to be about half of that. So I would suggest that you set it at 400 pixels wide and the height around 550 to 600 pixels. Now you can see that that updates it in the embed code. You don't need to know what this embed code means. All you have to do is copy it. If you go to ItsLearning now, and let's say you have an ItsLearning page, I'm going to change the layout to two columns because most people have a two column page layout. I'm going to add a content block, and I can add a rich content block. So that's pretty straightforward. I'm going to name the block, and in here, I can't just paste the code in because it's going to come up just as text in ItsLearning. What I need to do, once I get that in the right place, what I need to do is not paste it straight into the text box. First, I need to click on the source button, and in here I can enter the code. And the code, if I turn the source back off, you can see that there's an iframe there, and that will be actually the embedded content. If I click OK, you can see now that my Word document is embedded in my ItsLearning page. Finally, I need to add a link for users so that they can actually edit this document. So unfortunately, we can't edit within ItsLearning, but you can create a link where students can click or teachers can click and update that document. So I need to go back to my OneDrive document. I can close the embed window now, and I want to click share up here. I'm pretty sure you can also do it in the same place. You can see share with people, the same place as the embed code, but you don't want to share it with people. You want to get a link, and you can have no sign in required. That just makes it much easier for students and teachers to access. If it's confidential information, then you can say that they must have a Munich International School account required. So you can have a view link, but that's what we already have in our blog. What you should have is an edit link with no sign in required. Then finally, you can copy this link here. And this is the link that you need to put into your frame somewhere within that rich content block. I'm going to put it at the top so the students can see it first. And again, if I just paste in the link, it's pretty ugly, one. And two, it's not clickable. It's just text. So what I want to do is not paste the link in. I can make it a little bit fancier by writing a little passage. So I'm going to say, click here to edit this document. And if I highlight that, I can link that text. If I press the link button here, you can see it's three links of a chain. If I click that button and paste and click OK, you can see it's blue and underlined, which generally means it's a link. If I click OK, I can click that link as a student or a teacher, and it will take me to that OneDrive document so that I can edit it. So I just clicked it. You can see it opened it up in a new document here. And for me to edit that, all I have to do is click edit document and edit in browser. And then I can edit that document, and any edits that I make also update in that embed window. Thank you.